My name is Michael Trigliano II, bastardized very much in the United States as Srigliano. I'm the managing editor of digital content at the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York. And I'm here to present the Heilbrunn Timeline of Art History, which was the 2017 Webby Award for Best Art Website. The thesis of the Heilbrunn Timeline of Art History is remarkably simple. The Metropolitan Museum of Art is in a unique position as an encyclopedic institution to present the history of art through its unparalleled collection, representing more than 5,000 years of creativity from across the globe, from the first cities of the ancient Near East to works being created today. By leveraging the scholarship of the Metropolitan's curators, conservators, educators, research associates, and other expert contributors, the timeline has become a premier reference research and teaching tool used by students and educators and anyone interested in the study of art history and related subjects. The key to the timeline's success is the way in which the publication integrates all of its content, which includes thematic essays, works of art, chronologies, and keywords, thus providing every user with an unending path of discovery to feed their curiosity. Anyone could begin their journey on the timeline by exploring 20th century Cubist works of Fernand Léger, for example, and end their session learning about the Lamassu, who guard the museum's Assyrian sculpture court from the first century BC. Thank you to the Wayback Machine for these screenshots from the early 2000s. The Met launched the timeline in October 2000, seeking to create a trusted and accessible educational resource in the very early days of the internet as we now know it. As a point of comparison, the timeline was released into the world before even the first version of Wikipedia, which launched 3 months later in January 2001. The first iteration of the timeline allowed users to explore various chronologies by selecting from a number of geographic areas on a world map. Each chronology would present information about Met objects created within that time frame and in that section of the world, as well as other historical information with which the reader could contextualize the art. Also included in this first iteration was a small group of 40 essays, which were then known just as special topics, which represented the scholarship of just 5 of the museum's 17 curatorial departments. Topics explored in this first batch covered the time periods from prehistory through the late 18th century and explored topics such as art of the Fatimid period, trade routes between Europe and Asia and antiquity, the empires of the Western Sudan, warfare in ancient Greece, and Egypt in the Old Kingdom. About 50 new special topics were added each year through 2004, at which point the publication boasted roughly 250 essays that provided a holistic overview of the entire Met collection, all 17 of its curatorial departments, and art history through to the present day. As with any digital product, the timeline started small and then expanded in scope. These special topics published in the first 5 years were essentially stubs, about 2 to 3 paragraphs of text with no authorial byline, bibliographic entries, or integration with other special topics or content on the site. Each essay was illustrated by no more than 8 works of art from the collection, and those pages contained just a thumbnail image, basic tombstone text, and a short chat label. After we achieved that first critical mass of essays, work began to expand the timeline's user face and make it the comprehensive publication that students enjoy today. As mentioned before, the key to the timeline is its integration of content. Unlike a textbook, which provides its readers with a prescribed linear take on the development of art over millennia, the timeline makes no statement about how a reader should explore or categorize the development of art as a whole. Instead, it allows readers to forge their own connections among the hundreds of essays and thousands of works of art presented on the publication. This is done by presenting users with various facets of related material, which are presented on the right-hand side of any page on the timeline. These include primary and secondary essays related to the topic page that the reader is on, as well as chronologies, related keywords, artists, makers, and a link to see all essays from a thematic area. For example, here, you could get to all essays related to Greek and Roman art. Should readers also be interested in other digital content produced by the museum related to topics covered on the timeline, we provide links that take them to related Met exhibitions, articles published on our Webby Award-winning blogs platform, as well as video content and other web features. So a reader who wants to learn about the role of hippopotami in ancient Egypt has the opportunity to click through to a blog article about the museum's unofficial mascot, William the Hippo, a blue faience figure from the Middle Kingdom's 12th dynasty. This blog article discusses recent conservation work performed on William, which is essentially, as you can see from these pictures, the museum equivalent of an annual checkup. Also, an essay on the Spanish guitar, written by a former curatorial fellow in our musical instruments department, is supplemented by links to a series of videos showing modern guitarists performing Spanish repertoire on instruments from the Met's collection. With so much to explore, it may seem difficult to find a proper starting point, but in all actuality, any page on the timeline is an ideal starting point, one that could lead readers across hundreds of years and travel throughout the world and back. So let's go on a typical reader journey. Someone with an interest in the work of Albrecht Dürer can read an essay on the artist's life, his training, and work before exploring such primary essays as Anatomy in the Renaissance or History of Engraving and Woodcut in Western Art. To gain a wider view of Renaissance art, readers can select from a batch of secondary essays to read about Dutch and Flemish artists at work in Rome in the 16th century, representations of the nude form in the Middle Ages and the Renaissance, or woodcut book illustrations in late 15th century Florence. Works of art from the Met collection are presented with each essay and provide additional opportunities for inspiration and the exploration of deeper connections. The same Dürer essay here is illustrated by 18 works from our collection by the artist, which readers could click on in order to learn more about the individual art. So the artwork page for Dürer's 1505 oil on linden painting, Salvator Mundi, presents to readers all core tombstone information and a chat label for the work, as well as a high resolution photograph and a link to the object information on our online collection, which provides much more information, including provenance, exhibition history, catalog entries, and high resolution images that are downloaded free of charge as part of our open access policy. Additionally, on these pages, readers can explore the chronology to which this work belongs, which in this case, Central Europe, 1400 to 1600 AD, as well as related keywords, an artist tag for Dürer, and a selection of essays related specifically to that artwork. Salvator Mundi is a great example of the rabbit hole that the timeline provides to its readers. One of the essays related to this work is Unfinished Works in European Art, circa 1500 to 1900. A rich text that surveys the notion of the unfinished or non finito in Western art through an examination and discussion of works by artists from Peter Bruegel the Elder and El Greco to Edouard Manet and Winslow Homer. Through this nonlinear approach to art history, readers can discover relationships and points of comparison across centuries of artistic practice conducted by artists from across the world, separated by hundreds of years. The artist tag for Winslow Homer, included in this artwork's record, connects to the artist tag for Homer's contemporary, John Singer Sargent, which brings readers to an essay about Sargent's life and work. From that essay, one could then discover an episode from the Met's Artist Project video series, which we produced in 2015 and 2016, in which the museum invited 120 artists to choose individual works of art or galleries at the Met that sparked their imaginations. In this episode, Kehinde Wiley, who recently painted the official portrait of former United States President Barack Obama, mused on his admiration for Sargent's painting and the way in which it inspired his own work. The timeline also gives readers the framework to understand political and cultural information outside the realm of art history. Each of the 300 chronologies presented on the publication include a timeline, an overview of key events that occurred during that date range, and a related list of rulers. From the Durer essays chronology, readers can glean information about the various empires that ruled Central Europe during this period, learn about the Czech cleric Jan Hus's call for reform in the Catholic Church, or read about the death of Emperor Sigismund, which marked the end of Luxembourg rule in 1437. And just as the Met's collection grows each year, in order to better interpret our global heritage, new essays and works of art are added to the timeline every single month. Regular updates to scholarship and works of art expand points of entry for every reader and deepen our collective understanding of art history, from a Neolithic bowl created in the late 8th millennium BC to works as recent as William Kentridge's The Refusal of Time from 2012, and a painting by Iranian artist Nasrullah Afjai from 2013. Since its inception in 2000, the timeline has grown to comprise more than 1,000 essays, nearly 8,000 works of art, 300 chronologies, and 4,000 keywords. The publication garners more than 18 million page views a year, or essentially one quarter of all traffic on metmuseum.org. According to the museum's mission statement, the Met was founded in 1870 for the purpose of, quote, encouraging and developing the study of the fine arts, of advancing the general knowledge of kindred subjects, and to that end, of furnishing popular instruction, end quote. As such, the timeline of art history is an emphatic example of the Met's dedication to providing accessible scholarship and educational resources about art history and its vast collection. In our current world of restricted online access and expensive content paywalls, the timeline of art history remains a free publication made readily available to any of the 4 billion internet-connected people on the planet, and is a powerful force in connecting those people to creativity, knowledge, and ideas. Thank you.